Yo, 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 what is good, everybody? Welcome back to the channel. It is a bright and early morning. It is Wednesday, the day before the Supreme drop, so you already know what time it is. We're here to review another drop list. This time around is week four. It's not a great drop list from what it seems. It looks like it's gonna be a pretty weak week. No pun intended there. But yeah, I am still going to review a few guys anyways. Hopefully you guys do like a couple pieces. I do have like one or two pieces in mind that I might try to cop online. I did pass for the in-store release because I didn't think that there was anything that was worth me leaving my house for. But nonetheless, I am still gonna go for some stuff online. So I will be having another live cop for you guys tomorrow. It won't be a great one, but you know, hopefully you guys can stay tuned for that as well. Tomorrow is also the release of the Yeezy Reflectives, the 350, the Cloud Whites. So I will be going for that as well. Maybe we can, you know, work something out with both of them together in the live cop. But for today, we do have a drop list review. Before I get into the video, of course, you already know, if this is the first time stopping by my channel or checking out any of my videos, go ahead, hit that subscribe button. It'll definitely be appreciated. I got content like this for you guys all the fucking time, so I do not think you guys will be disappointed in subscribing. So please, real quick, take a second, hit that subscribe button. Also, I'm giving away a Fall Winter 18 box logo. If you haven't already heard, if you haven't already entered, you're sleeping on it, please go check that out. I'll leave the video somewhere on the screen and in the description below so you guys can go check that out. But there's not a lot more time to enter, so stop sleeping on it. Go enter that shit now. But into the actual video, I'm gonna swap over to my setup, pull up Supreme Community, and yeah, like always, show you guys what to do. All right, let's get right into it. Let me pull up Supreme Community and see what Supreme Week 4 has in store for us. Definitely a lot of garbage from what I've seen, but let's see. Let's start at the bottom like we usually do, work our way up, like always, with the least liked items. Let's start with this Flower Jacquard 5 panel. This is absolutely garbage. It does have some embroidery on it, but the flowers, the colors, the pinstripes, this is trash. And yeah, it seems like a lot of people are agreeing with me. If you're going for this for resale, I would definitely pass on it. Price is probably gonna be, yeah, $48. The good thing is about this week with me doing the review, I actually have prices, you know, which is great. Usually I'm just, you know, estimating the prices and I'm not usually far off, but it's always nice to have the exact prices. But this is garbage. I would definitely pass on that if I were you guys. Next, we have this denim shirt. This denim shirt is actually not bad. I would actually wear this denim shirt. I just wouldn't pay full retail for it. Yeah, the 128 price point on it is a bit high. This is something that you can probably find at the end of the season with, you know, during the sale or even like in the aftermarket. Somebody will probably cop it and not fit them, or they like, you know, regret buying it, and you can probably find it for a pretty good price. All the colors in the stripes are pretty dope. I would probably pass on this, you know, full, you know, denim one, but the yellow one, the red one, the blue one, all the striped ones are pretty fire in my opinion. For like a casual, business casual shirt, if you want to pull up to work with it, this is definitely a fire shirt. But I'll probably pass on that if you're looking to resell it. Next we have the chenille stripe beanie. I just don't know what is going on with Supreme and their beanies nowadays. This is complete trash. The colors are trash, with exception to maybe this black and white one, because I do like muted colors, but Jesus Christ, this is bad. I like the logo, I just don't like the placement of it. I don't like how big it is. This is just not a good beanie in my opinion. But $36 as usual. Would I go for it if I were reselling it? Probably not. I probably would stay away from it as well if I were you guys. Next, we have the first piece of the collaboration this week. The collaboration this week is with The Velvet Underground. If you guys don't know, The Velvet Underground is an NYC-based rock band. I personally have no experience listening to their music. I'm not really a big rockhead, but I do know that, you know, they have their fans. A lot of people aren't feeling this collaboration, which is, I'm not sure if I should call it weird or if I should call it, you know, expected. But me personally, I'm not really feeling this collaboration. I'm probably going to pass on all the pieces. I would say that this ringer tee, the way it looks, with exception to like the graphic, is pretty dope. I've always been a pretty big fan of ringer tees, but this one specifically here, I have really no, you know, connection to it, so I'm probably gonna pass on it. But it's probably going to be on the more expensive side. Yep, $98. The colors aren't bad in my opinion. I feel the colors are actually pretty dope, but would I pay $98? Probably not. If you're a fan of the Velvet Underground, then sure, go for it. It's definitely, you know, something that you'll probably appreciate. But if you're going to resell it, probably stay away from that as well. But that is the ringer tee, a pretty, you know, whatever tee if you ask me. Next, definitely one of my favorite pieces dropping this week. I'm not sure why it's getting so much hate. It's the quilted paisley jacket. When I saw this during the preview, I was super stoked to, you know, to see it. I'm not sure why people are not feeling it. I love the paisley pattern. I love the corduroy collar. I love the way they contrast with each other. The embroidery on the back is super, super, super clean and super dope. I really like this jacket, and I don't even think the price point is that bad. Yeah, $188. It's better than the fleece jacket that dropped last week in terms of pricing, not actually, you know, in terms of it being better. But this is a fire jacket, if you ask me. The only thing I'm not a fan of with this jacket is the bottom here. The way they cut the bottom. I wish they would have maybe made it a bit more fitted, but it doesn't seem like it's a heavy jacket, so that would explain the reason why they cut it like that. But this jacket is fire. This yellow is the one, in my opinion. The blue one isn't bad, but this yellow one is fucking elite. Elite. I'm actually considering going it for myself, to be honest. I don't think that it'll resell. Maybe in like a small or extra large, you can get some, you know, maybe like 50, 60 bucks on it, which is not bad. Of course, $56 on top of anything isn't usually bad. But, you know, if it were like back in the days, this is a piece that will go for a lot of money. Nowadays, with, you know, with this type of sellers that are in this market, you really can't expect much. But nonetheless, if you're looking to cop this for personal, this is definitely a sick, sick, sick jacket. But next, we have this Radar beanie. This is a complete just a mystery, in my opinion. I was not around during the time where this type of beanie was popping. I know a lot of people who like it, you know, with the brim. I personally would just never wear something like this. Not that I have anything against it, I just don't understand it. I would just either wear a fitted, a snapback, or a beanie. I don't need to, you know, combine both. But for those people who do, you can actually, you know, go cop this. This is gonna be 36 bucks. The colors are not bad. I do not expect it to resell. So yeah, the classic logo does add a bit, you know, of a better look to it, if you ask me though. But I will be passing on that. Next, we have this raised logo sweater. This we saw during the lookbook, and I don't mind the crew neck, I don't mind the sweater. I just don't like the colors that they use. I feel the colors were a complete disaster. This neon green is trash. The navy, I never like navy. Black is whatever, it's probably gonna do the best if you're looking to resell it, even though they're probably not gonna be, it's probably not gonna go for a lot more over. The red one is whatever. This is probably going to cost, I was gonna say $128, $138, so $10 more. Not bad for a sweater, but is it worth it? Probably not, if you ask me. But yeah, I'm just going to move on. Next, we have this cat long sleeve pocket tee. This pocket tee is actually, in my opinion, is not bad. I know a lot of people are probably just confused when they see a cat on a Supreme tee. I really do like this tee though, in my opinion. I know of a lot of people who are also a big fan of this graphic. The problem with this long sleeve is that it's going to be pretty expensive because it is an all cotton jersey, $78. For a long sleeve, I know it's the type of season that, you know, long sleeves are pretty needed. That's why I would say that this is a good cop. For personal, that is, for resale, I don't think it's gonna do much, even though like this washed blue one, the pink one, and even this green one are pretty fire. I don't think it's gonna do much in the resale market. But if you're looking to cop it for personal, I do think that this is a fire, fire long sleeve top to cop. And it has like the little Supreme branding on the, what is that, the left sleeve at the bottom. Not bad at all. I actually really like this piece, to be honest. Next, we have this love-hate baseball jersey. To be honest, I have like a love-hate relationship with this jersey itself. I like the fact that it's a baseball jersey because I'm a really, really big fan of baseball jerseys, especially Supreme baseball jerseys. I just hate this fucking design. I'm not sure why they went with the pinstripes. I'm not sure why they didn't separate it with the back. Like, I wanna see the back, to be honest, because the back is plain. It's, you know, they left so much room for this type of branding to be on the back as well. Maybe like putting the Supreme Randy 4 on the back with the love hate on the front would have been sick. But if they just left all of the branding on the front and nothing on the back, it's just like, come on, Supreme, what the fuck are you guys doing? But personally, I'm going to pass on this. If this was like 3 years ago, 4 or 5 years ago, maybe this jersey would have done numbers. But you know, I'm just not feeling it, to be honest. I do think that this red one is super, super fire. I like the way the gold and the white contrasts with the red. I do not like the teal one. I know a lot of people are probably feeling the teal one the most. I'm not sure, I'm just assuming, but I think the red one and the black one are super dope. It's going to be 110, which is actually not bad. I was going to say 138. 110 is not bad for the jersey. I do think it could have been worse, but do I think it's going to resell? Maybe for a couple dollars over. I don't think it's gonna be anything crazy. If you're looking to go for it, I don't think that you'll be completely upset with the return, but I would say tread lightly on this piece. Next, we have this Delta logo varsity jacket. This varsity jacket, in my opinion, is actually not bad. Not bad at all, especially for the price, $338. Definitely a great price point for a varsity jacket, especially ones with embroidered logos on them. I know for a fact in the past we've seen varsity jackets go for like $450. In fact, the Motion logo varsity jacket that dropped a couple years ago or a couple seasons ago retailed for $458, which was, yeah, definitely much less branding than this. And it is good time for a varsity jacket, so I do think that this is a piece that has potential. Now, will I go for this? Probably not, simply because I don't want to, you know, I don't want to take a risk on something, you know, sitting in my house. I have enough inventory already. I do think that in the right size, like in a small or extra large, I do think that this piece can go for a couple dollars over. But I would say even more so, if you want this for personal, I would say go for it. For resale, I would say, you know, maybe hold off, because there will be better jackets dropping. But if you want it, if you like it, go for it. This is the first time that we've seen this logo on any piece, so it does have potential. But me personally, I'm just going to pass on it. Next, we have more collaboration pieces. We have this drawings tee. This tee is actually, you know, it's pretty all right. It's probably one of the only pieces out of the collaboration that, you know, you don't really have to be a fan of the band to actually rock, even though you'll probably still get questioned on the street if, you know, on your knowledge of the band. But this piece is actually not bad. I usually like, you know, graphics with, you know, with just drawings on it, like just random, you know, cartoon drawings. But will I cop this? Simply because it's a tee, I might think about it. I actually like the colors as well, like the slate. This yellow one is actually not bad either. The white, obviously you can't go wrong with white. But this is probably gonna retail for $48. Yep, $48. I don't know, it's whatever. If you like the band, I would say go for it. If you're not and you're looking to resell it, I would say you can probably make like a couple dollars off of it, but nothing really crazy. Next, we have this Velvet Underground Rayon shirt. Actually, in my opinion, this graphic is not bad. What killed this rayon shirt is the way they cut it. The back, it being like rounded, is really bad in my opinion. I feel like they should have just cut it like usual rayon shirts, but it's not my call to make. This graphic, I actually heard, came from one of the Velvet Underground's album covers. Yeah, the Loaded album. I actually really like the graphic. I like the way it sits on the shirt. I'm just not a fan of the way they cut the shirt. But it is what it is. I do not think this shirt would resell for much. It's going to cost, yeah, a bit more expensive, $158. I'll probably just stay away from this piece myself. But if you want to go for it for personal, it's definitely not a bad piece. If you want to resell it, I'd say tread lightly for sure. But up next, we have this Jacquard logo twill camp cap. This is actually a great hat to cop. I personally always cop the black ones. This tan one is really nice, considering it's the only one with a red box logo. Obviously the red one has a red box logo as well, but this one with the contrasting box logo is not bad. It's probably gonna cost $48. Great price. I actually really like this hat, to be honest. The yellow one is fire, the green one is fire. I have a purple one, I have a black one. I would probably go ahead and cop this tan one, to be honest. It's really fire. And these hats will probably have some resale to them as well. People are always eating up these 12 cam caps. So yeah, if you wanna go for this is probably one of the better items to go for this week, especially at $48. Great price point. Next, we have more Velvet Underground tees. This tee here appears to be very similar. It has a little Supreme box logo on the front. I believe these are the 5 original band members, which is pretty dope. In the back, I believe we have the graphic from the debut album. I'm not really sure. Again, I've done very minimal research, but it is a pretty all right tee in my opinion. It's like a tour tee, very similar to like a tour tee. If you know, for those people out there who are a fan of this group and like tour tees, this is definitely for you guys. Again, the colors of the tees are not bad. I do think that this tee can have some resale because it does have like, you know, a more cleaner graphic on it. But me personally, I'll probably cop one just because I don't want to overdo it. Maybe you can get like $25-$30 on it. This is probably going to retail for $48, just like the other one, which isn't bad. But if I would say, more importantly, for the people who like the band, I would say this is a great cop. Definitely a dope tee if you ask me. But up next, we have another collaboration album. This is the hooded sweatshirt, the Nico hooded sweatshirt. This piece is actually fire, in my opinion, and I'm probably only saying that because of my bias for all over print hoodies. This is a sick, sick hoodie. I'm definitely not saying that because of the collaboration. I'm saying that because of the way the hoodie looks. The colors are dope, like the hints of green, the black, the red. I think this is a fire hoodie. This is probably the only piece that you can get away with putting on if you're not a fan of the actual band. Like me personally, with the very minimal knowledge that I have of the band, I can probably still get away with rocking this hoodie simply because it's not, you know, over the top, the velvet on the ground. But super, super fire. It's probably going to retail for $198. Yep, like all overprint hoodies do. This is fire, in my opinion. This will probably have some resale to it as well. I would say maybe like 75 bucks over you can get, which is definitely, you know, great turnaround, but definitely a super, super, super fire hoodie. I really fuck with that hoodie. Next, we have the Delta logo keychain. This is all right, pretty whatever piece. If you ask me, 24 bucks. If you want a keychain, you can cop a keychain. I'm not really gonna spend a lot of time on a keychain. But next we have paneled art hooded sweatshirt. This piece, I'm not sure why a lot of people are fucking with it. This piece is disgusting in my opinion. I don't like the graphic, I don't like the art logo on it, I don't like the panels, the colors are trash. Yeah, this is a brick in my opinion. This is the type of item that you see a lot of people upvote and then come in store or come online, a lot of people cop it and it bricks simply because it's just not a dope hoodie, to be honest. It has embroidered ARC logo on it, which is, you know, makes it a little better, but I just don't like the way the graphic sits on the actual, you know, garment itself. But this tan one, yeah, it's trash. The Gucci colorway is probably gonna do the best. This blue one, I don't know why there's like two iterations of blue. They probably could have done a different color. Maybe like a purple would have been nice, or like a gray maybe, I'm not sure. This is just not it, to be honest. 168, yeah, I'll probably pass on that if you're looking to resell it. For personal, I guess it's a pretty all right hoodie, but for resale, I'd say definitely tread lightly with that cop. Next, we have this velvet underground tee, another underground tee. This is actually not a bad t-shirt either. It looks like it has the band numbers on the front with the Supreme Box logo, very similar to like a photo tee. And on the back, I'm not sure what this is. It looks like it's probably another album cover, which is, you know, pretty dope. If, again, if you're a fan of the band, I'd say this is all for you. Me personally, I'm probably gonna pass on it. $48, definitely not a bad price point. It's a t-shirt, so nothing really to be, you know, said there. Next, we have a hooded sweatshirt with the same graphic on it, with the same graphic on the front. On the back, I believe you have the track list of the album. There's no larger photo of the back, but this hoodie is actually, you know, not bad. I think that this is probably, you know, one of the better items out of the collaboration, and I'm probably only saying that because I like hoodies, but this piece is actually not bad. It's probably gonna retail for, oh, I was gonna say 158. Wow, that's really expensive. 178, maybe because it's a collaboration, it's a bit more expensive. But yeah, I don't think it's a bad hoodie. Will it resell at that price? Maybe you can get like 30 bucks on it, 30, 40 bucks, maybe with the, you know, with the chance that it can appreciate in the future. But in my opinion, this piece is actually pretty dope, honestly. But lastly, with the last item to be confirmed this week, we have the vacuum insulated bottles. These are always cops. I have a few insulated bottles from previous seasons and they do really well. This one is probably one of the better ones in a while. I really like this black one. I really like the red one. They're both fire. I think that you can make money on both. It's probably going to retail for $46. I was actually gonna say $48, $2, not a big difference. But this is a fire accessory for those who, you know, are always on the go and you need your stuff, you know, always hot. If you like to drink hot chocolate or if you like to drink tea, this is for you. This is definitely a fire accessory to have. But I do think that it's worth going for. This is one of the pieces that I'll probably be going for in multiples. Let's see how that goes tomorrow. But that is my review of the drop list for week 4. I do think that tomorrow is a good day to sleep in. I don't think that you'll be missing out on a lot. If you're a fan of the Velvet Underground, then you do have some pieces that you can probably cop for your personal collection. Me personally, again, I'm not a fan of it, so I'll probably be passing on the majority of that stuff. But I do hope you guys enjoyed it. I hope you guys took away some valuable info. If you did, please drop a like, comment your thoughts, and subscribe to the channel. It'll definitely be appreciated. Also, go follow me on Instagram. My Instagram is pretty fire. As always, I have to mention that. So please go check that out. Show love to your boy. But until next time, peace.